All right, so on assignment two, I'm going to go over it really, really quickly, and then I will show you, I'll have to show you some of the specifics next time, but everything is actually in the instructions. Okay, assignment two, screen design. All right, you are going to be designing your first interface. Yay! Now, some of you are probably saying, I thought you said I didn't have to code. You don't. You are going to be using two tools that are used very commonly out in industry. I just so happen to have links to those tools down here. One of them is iPlots. It is web-based. The other is AXRRP. AXRRP is a desktop-based system. For AXRRP, there is a temporary license available. It is installed in all of the computer science labs. There is also a temporary license that you can use till the end of the semester. Till the end of the semester, if you want to install it on your laptop or desktop. Let me go through this really quickly. Down here with the resources, we'll go through the resources more carefully on Tuesday. But to give you an idea, you are going to be creating an interface. All right, it is it will be an interactive interface, but it doesn't actually have to work. One that will have to work, you'll have to do later on. But it's a lot of drop and drag, as you'll see. There's no coding involved. FIU is hosting a scavenger hunt for teams between 3 and 5 people. All team members must wear matching shirts with FIU's logo and a team name. Each team leader must place only one order for the entire team. You've been asked to design the screen that will be used for taking the t-shirt orders. So, here's a list of requirements. These are all things that must be included in terms of your data collection. On your screen, on your interface, when it comes to placing this order. Also, each t-shirt costs $10, and the form must display the total order cost. Now, you don't actually have to do the calculation. You must have at least a placeholder for it. You can, of course, if you want to delve that much into AXRRP this time, have it calculate, but you don't have to this time. It must provide buttons to place the order, clear the form, and cancel the order or exit the application. I will tell you the one thing I'm going to be focusing on the most is, are you meeting all of these requirements? Of course, I'm also going to look at your ability to apply what we've learned so far to design something that's usable. But my primary focus is actually going to be, did you adhere to the requirements? Okay, so let me quickly go through your tasks. Oh, let me mention one thing. One thing to keep in mind. Sometimes students will only focus on the bulleted list. Is that the only place that you find requirements? No, it's not. There are requirements in the first paragraph and in this paragraph. So remember that. Oh, here's one more thing. Eventually, I will be randomly selecting some of your interfaces. It'll be anonymous, and we are going to analyze them in class. Yay, no one will know who you are if you're chosen unless you decide you want to volunteer that information. And of course, if you want to get feedback on your interface, feel free to volunteer. I actually have students who do that, by the way. All right, your first task, you are going to go to something that you are not used to, a piece of paper, actually 3 pieces of paper. And you're going to engage in something that is very similar to what's called paper prototyping. Basically, I want you to sketch out 3 potential versions of your interface. You know, with either a pen and paper or a pencil and paper. I know it's foreign to us these days. But it doesn't have to be pretty. But you need to be able to understand what you've drawn. Typically, what happens is you'll draw one. You'll say, oh, here's something I can improve. The second one will be an improved version. The third one will be an improved version over that one. Typically, that's how students do that. Not always. So I want you to create at least three different layouts. And you guys will be turning this in. You can either turn it in the papers themselves, or you can scan them and upload them. The online course will scan them in and upload them. Or you can take a picture with your phone. By the way, it's something most students do these days. I want you to look at them, choose the one that you think is the most usable, that is the best design. Step two, you're going to go to iPlots, iPlots.com. I'll show this to you on Tuesday. You can go look at it between now and, Thursday, between now and Thursday. You are going to recreate your best sketch. You're then going to print this out. You will copy and paste it into a Word document. You will then take this sketch and you will show it to at least two people. But one of the things that's critical when you show it to them, you must have them act as if they are actually using the form. I'll show you a video on Tuesday, an example of this. If you just show it to them and ask them for feedback, you're going to get very different feedback. And you probably won't do very well on this particular assignment. Make sure you have them actually try to place an order and get feedback from them. You want to write all that down because you need to include that in your Word document. You must include why you selected your design and the feedback from at least two users. Then I want you to write down what are you going to be changing about your interface based on that feedback. Then you are going to go and create the actual interactive interface in AXRRP. You'll see it's pretty easy. When you create an AXRRP, one of the things ultimately you're going to have to do is you're going to have to create a prototype and upload it to a web service. Because I am not going to look at your AXRRP file. I am going to click on a link that you are going to include in your Word document. So what does that mean? If it's on your hard drive, I can't see it. Sounds obvious, right? Every semester I get a link to someone's hard drive. So please make sure that you put it on up on the web. I must be able to access it via the web. There are two ways that you can do it. You do have some space for via FIU and via CS. A much easier way is you can create a free account at AXRRP. I think it's share.axrrp.com. And there's a nice command in AXRRP, create your prototype and upload it. And then it will generate a link. And here's one more thing. Please don't password protect your link. Because then I click on it and it asks me for a password. And guess what I have? Nothing. So then what do you get in the comments about your assignment? Yeah, I see nothing.